Hi guys, welcome back. Today we are diving into the world of single board computers, otherwise known as SBCs. We are right in the middle of 2023, and boy, we've seen a number of remarkable SBCs over the past year. It's high time we take a look at the top 5 that stand out in terms of affordability, features and performance. And just to clarify, we are focusing on the consumer grade of SBCs here. These tiny powerhouses are perfect for hobbyists, thinkers, and other enthusiasts. SBCs are ideal for a wide range of applications. Want to build a home media center? You got it. Interested in creating a personal server or a home lab full of servers? No problemo. Or perhaps you're looking to learn more about programming and DevOps? Single board computers are your perfect stepping stone into these arenas. And the best part? You don't need to empty your wallet to get hold of one. So let's not waste any more time and dive into the top SBCs of 2023. Listen. Number 0. Let's address the elephant in the room before we jump into our top 5. The Raspberry Pi, today the 4B model. This pioneer in single board computers is well known amongst the masses, no need to introduce it. Also, it's the sole reason why most people hold a grudge against Ibn Upton, the CEO of Raspberry Pi Foundation. Though I heard he's a nice guy, we just can't forgive him for his optimistic promises about production recovery and restocking. Sadly, these promises have yet to materialize in many parts of the world. However, today we are looking beyond the Raspberry Pi to some other intriguing options on the market. Starting at number 5, we have the Odroid H3 Plus from Hardkernel. I have started a little bit unconventionally here. This computer is running on an Intel processor, not ARM, as you would expect in this list. And that's the thing that makes it so special. It's running the Intel quad-core processor Jasper Lake N6005, and you can feed an impressive 64 GB of RAM to it. At $165, it offers high performance with interesting options resulting from the Intel architecture. But the one downside is the price, which will go up as you buy more RAM and storage. Nevertheless, very solid choice. Number 4 on the list, we are looking at the Khadas Vim 4 by Shenzhen Vision Technology. This ARM-based device is powerhouse with 8 GB of RAM and an MLogic A311D2 SoC. It's great fit for diverse projects at $200. The price is again a bit higher, but this is no thing about Khadas devices. Know that it's mad price here, but a little. On the other hand, Khadas devices, at least from my experience, boast with reliability and their online support is great. This device can run Android, Ubuntu, Debian and Core Alec. It has its own installation wizard with an online service named Oh Wow that will make installation of the OSs on this device a breeze. Again, if you pick this device for your project, you will not regret it. For the third spot, we have the BananaPi W3 by Shenzhen's Sinovoip company. With one of the most powerful chips today, the Rockchip RK3588, 8 GB of RAM and compatibility with Linux and Android, it offers high performance at a very affordable price. The main reason I've put this board on this list is definitely the RK3588 chip and 2.5 GB Ethernet. Sadly, this board was somehow stripped down of one more Ethernet port and a few other things before it was released, but I find it still very capable SBC for your money. At number 2, we are featuring the Zimaboard A32 from Icewell Company, an Intel 64-bit based SBC with a Celeron N3450 quad-core CPU and 8 GB of RAM. It stands out with diverse OS compatibility, including Windows, Linux, CasaOS and FreeBSD. All this for $200. It's mid-range price for a high-performing Intel SBC. The Intel architecture lends this guy some unique capabilities that ARM would just not, like running Proxmox, a Type 1 hypervisor for virtual machines, so you can build a Proxmox cluster in your home lab. The other thing is the FreeBSD, which means you can run pfSense, an enterprise-grade router and firewall solution on this thing. Just one warning, if you plan to use it this way, buy an Intel network card for it. You will save yourself some headaches. Nonetheless, a very capable board with tons of accessories thanks to this external PCI Express slot. Thumbs up to Zimaboard. And at the top of our list, we have the OrangePi 5 Plus by Shenzhen Xunlong, a high performer that can't run anything else than the Rockchip RK3588 with support of 16 GB of RAM, multiple operating systems compatibility, Ubuntu, Debian, Android and the more interesting ones. Arch, Armbian and OpenWRT. It's got them all. I must say, OrangePi people do know what they are doing. 8-core computer supports encoding of 8K video, two 2.5 gig Ethernet ports, amazing. If you really need a network throughput, you can bond or aggregate these ports and get up to 5 gigabit per second network connection. That's wild. I won't even mention all the other whistles and bells this board offers. It's just pure winner. And the pricing? $135. God, how much lower can it be? I'm afraid at this point they're losing their money. And I don't want them to. I like their products. So, there you have it, the top 5 consumer-grade SBCs of mid-2023. All great choices, each offering something unique. Now it's your turn to dive in. Remember, the best SBC is the one that fits your project's needs and doesn't break your bank account. And the best SBC for you doesn't even need to be on this list. Take it with open mind and look for the best SBC for you. Happy tinkering, and don't forget to share your creations with our community. We can't wait to see what you're building. Before I sign off, I'd love to hear from you. Have you used any of these SBCs? Do you have a personal favorite or a different recommendation? Leave your thoughts in the comments below. And if you found this video helpful, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and share it with your friends. If you're new here, consider subscribing and hitting that bell icon so you won't miss my future videos. Thank you so much for watching, and until next time, keep exploring, keep learning, and keep creating. This is Helping Ninja signing off. Bye.